Good afternoon, children. How are you? I hope all are fine. The previous class we studied the comparison of numbers. Today, I hope all of them understood that. In this class, we are going to study the ascending order and descending order. Ascending order. Ascending order means arranging the given numbers in the order of smallest to largest. Ascending order means ascending order is the arranging the given
numbers to biggest, smallest to biggest. Ascending order means smallest to biggest. I will explain it with an example. Listen here. Arrange in ascending order. Arrange in ascending order. 4,896, 3,842, 2,184, 5,026. We have to arrange these numbers in ascending order. Ascending order means arranging the given numbers into smallest to biggest. First, you find out which is the smallest digit. Here, first you consider. Count the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All of them have 4-digit numbers. Then you consider thousands place. Here, 4. Here, 3. Here, 2. Here, 5. Again, you have to find out the smallest number. It is the smallest number here. 4, 3, 2. 5. It is the smallest. That is 2. Here you write 1. This is the smallest number. Next smallest number is what? 3, 4, 5. It's 3. Next, 4, 5. That is 4. Then 5. Then we have to arrange. First, 2184 is less than 3,842 less than third one 4,896 less than 5,026. Ascending order means arrange the given numbers into smallest to biggest. 2,184 less than 3,842 is less than 4,896 less than 5,026. Next problem. Three thousand eight hundred sixty-four, 1,989, 2,126,002. We have to arrange these numbers in the ascending order. First, you find out the smallest number. It is the first you consider thousand place. 3, 1, 2, 6. It is a small digit. That is 1. That is 1,989 is less than second number, that is 2. 2,100 20 is less than next 3864 is less than 6002. That is the ascending order. Next, descending order. Descending order means arranging the given numbers how biggest to smallest. Biggest to smallest. Ascending order means smallest to biggest. Descending means biggest to smallest. Descending order. That is biggest to smallest. First you write the biggest number. Okay, I will explain with an example. We have to arrange these numbers in descending order. Descending order means biggest to smallest. First, you find out the biggest number. Consider 1000 place. Here, all of them have 9. So, next we consider hundreds place. Hundred place here 1, here 8, here 2, then 1. Which is the biggest number? 1, 8, 2, 1. Which is the biggest? Here 8. So this is the biggest number. Next 9, 1, 9, 2, 9, 1. Here hundreds place 2. That is the second biggest number. Then 9, 1, 9, 1. Then you consider tens place. Here 8. Here 2. It is here 8. Then 2. Then how to write? First, 9812 is greater than 9218 is greater than 9189 is greater than 9128. Okay, next problem. We have to arrange these numbers in descending order. That means biggest to smallest. First, you find out the biggest number. First, listen here. This is 8. Consider thousands place. Here 3. Here 3. Here 7. This is the biggest. That is 8,468. Then second. Here 3, here 3, here 7. Then next 7,398. Then here 3, here 3. Then you consider next place, that is hundreds place. Here 7, here 8. That is great. 3,878. Then 3,794. Then how to write? 8,468 is greater than second one. 7,398 greater than 3,874. What do you mean? What is an ascending order and descending order? Ascending order means arrange the given numbers in the order of smallest to biggest, and descending order means are in the given numbers in the biggest to smallest. Okay, I hope all of them understood that. Next we are going to study forming largest and smallest numbers. Forming largest and smallest numbers. First question, the largest 4-digit number that can be formed using the digits 1, 2, 3, 4. The largest 4-digit number that can be formed use the digit 1, 2, 3, 4. Here there are 4 digits 1, 2, 3, 4. We have to find out the largest 4-digit number. First you write largest digit. First, which is the largest digit? Here that is 4. Then next largest number, which is that? That is 3. Then next largest number, 2. Then 1. This is the largest 4-digit number can be formed using the digit. What is the answer? 4321. Next question. The smallest 4-digit number that can be formed use the digit 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so smallest 4-digit number. This is the smallest 4-digit. First you write the smallest digit. This is the smallest digit in this set. That is 1. Next smallest, 2. Next, 3. Then 4. 1234 is the smallest 4-digit number that can be formed use the digit 1, 2, 3, 4. Next problem. The smallest 4-digit number that can be formed use the digit 2, 0, 8, and 4. Smallest 4-digit number. First you write the smallest digit. Which is the smallest digit here? 0. Then 2. Then 4. Then 8. But it is not a right. This is a wrong. Why? Remember that when we write the smallest number, 0 will come the second place. 0 will come the second place. Not the first. Then second number will occupy the first place. Second number will occupy the first place. That means 2 will occupy first place. Then 0 will come second place. Then 4, 8. That is the correct answer. 2, 0, 4, 8. That means when we write the smallest number, 0 will come the second place. Not first. And second smallest number will occupy the first place. I hope all of them understood that. Next. Even and odd numbers. Even and odd numbers. What do you mean by an even number? Even numbers means the numbers that can be divided into exact group of 2. that can be divided into exact group of twos are called even number. Even number means numbers that can be divided into exact group of twos. That are called even numbers. Then even numbers ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. Even numbers ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. So one example. Circle the even numbers in each row. First set 2015, 3218, 1221, 6223, 1028. Circle the even numbers in each row. Even numbers means the numbers that can be divided into exact group of twos. And an even number ends with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Circle the even numbers in each row. 2015, 3218, 1021, 6223, 1028. How to find out this even number? You consider ones place have 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. That is an even number. Okay, here is 5. That is not an even number. Here ones place is 8. So 3218 is an even number. Then here ones place 1. Then here 3, here 8. So 1028 is a even number. That you consider ones place. Ones place occupies 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. That number is even number. Next example. Circle the even number in each row. First, you consider the ones place. If ones place has 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8, that number is an even number. Here, ones place is 9. 9 is not an even number. Then here, 0. 0, even number ends with a 0. So, this is an even number. Then ones place 6. 6. Even number end with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. So this is an even number. Then here 4. That is even number. Do you understand? Next, we are going to study what is an odd number. Odd number means the numbers that cannot be divided into exact group of 2. Odd number means the numbers that cannot be divided into exact group of 2. Listen here. Odd numbers means the numbers that cannot be divided into exact group of twos. Then odd number ends with 1, 3, 5, 7, or 9. Odd number end with 1, 3, 5, 7, or 9. 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9. Example. Here a set of numbers. We have to circle the odd number. You circle the odd number 7,296, 9,879, 6,211, 8,417. You consider ones digit here 6. 6, that is an even number. Then here 9. An odd number end with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 is an odd number. Next. Here, ones place 1. That is an odd number. Here, 7. Ones place, that is 8,417 is an odd number. Next example. Circle the odd number. Here 1,243, 3,468, 4,387, 7,640. You circle the odd number. You remember that ones place. Here ones place what? 3. The number ends with 3. So this number is an odd number. Next 3,468. Here ones place 8. That's an even number. Here 7. That is odd number. Here 0. That is an even number. Okay. Do you understand? What do you mean by an even and odd number? Even number means numbers that can be divided into exact group of 2's. And odd number means numbers that cannot be divided into exact group of 2's. Let's watch a video.
Even and odd numbers. Mr. Duck is a good fruit seller. He always brings fresh fruits to sell to his customers. He generally keeps 2 fruits of each kind in 1 basket. Today also, he is filling 6 of his baskets with fresh fruits. For this, he chooses some fruits like apples, bananas, oranges and mangoes and keeps them as shown. He takes 12 apples and keeps them in the groups of 2. Observe that no apple is left with him. He then takes 9 bananas. 1 banana is left with him on filling 4 baskets. He keeps 10 oranges in 5 baskets. Observe that no orange is left with him. Then he takes 13 mangoes, keeps them in groups of 2 in each basket and is left with 1 mango. Now observe the numbers 12, 9, 10 and 13. Out of these numbers, 12 and 10 can be grouped into pairs, while 9 and 13 cannot be grouped into pairs. The numbers which can be grouped into pairs are called even numbers. For example, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and so on. The numbers which cannot be grouped into pairs are called odd numbers. For example, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on. From this we can say that starting from 1, every second number is odd and the others are even. Observe the ones digits of these numbers carefully. Here, we find that all even numbers have 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 at the ones place. Whereas all odd numbers have 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 at the ones place. Thus, we can say that the numbers which end with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 are odd numbers. And the numbers which end with 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 are even numbers.
I hope all of them understood that. Next, I am going to show some numbers. Can you say that is even or odd? That is 6211. This is an odd number. Then 999. This is even or odd? This is an odd number. Next, 9999. Can you say this is even or odd? This is an odd number. Then 3280. This is an even number. 99. This is even or odd? This is an odd number. Then 8470. This is an odd number. I hope all of them understood that. Next class we will meet again. Okay, thank you.